Welcome, ladies and gentlemen, to Sweet Reality Kenya TV. And today we are hosting Dan Wandeo. Dan Wandeo, aka Dick.
Yes.
Dick is your nickname, right?
Dick is a nickname.
Uh-huh. How did you get this name, Dick?
I'm told I was named after a padre, Thomas Ogombe. Ogombe comes from Nyangera. He used to call himself Dick.
Okay.
So my father chose to have that name to be put on me because I was named after him.
Okay.
One of my official names is Thoma. So Thoma was part of his name.
Okay.
So I acquired the name Dick.
Okay.
Yes.
So maybe you do a formal introduction. Who is Dan Dick Wandeo?
I'm a Kenyan, born and brought up in Yimbo East, currently referred to as Yimbo Eastward, that is in Bondo constituency, Siaya County. I was born in the year 1970. To my parents, my father, the late Josiah Wandeo, and Mama Priska Meyai. They're both the late.
Okay.
My home village is Ngwenyo. Ngwenyo is in North Yimbo location. Barakanyango sub location.
Okay.
I'm a businessman currently, having worked in the government from the year 1988. After some time, the year 2008, that I left the government to do business.
Okay.
Yes.
Now, Dick Wandeo is will be contesting in 2022.
Correct.
And you also contested for MCA East Yimbo in 2017.
True.
Yes. Why did you take the seat?
In politics, people compete. And in competition, there must be a loser.
So you lost?
I lost.
Uh-huh.
Whether fairly or unfairly, I lost.
Mm.
The bottom line, I'm not the MCA.
Mm-hmm.
There's somebody who is sitting in that seat.
What strategies are you have you put in now so that you don't lose again?
The strategies, sometimes I may treat them as confidential.
Okay.
Because we are still going for a contest.
Mm-hmm.
I wanted to tell you that in 2022, I'll be in the race. The interview we are carrying out is going to be publicized. So the moment I give out my strategy in public right now, somebody may take that to counter, and I will still lose. And I don't want to lose.
You don't want
so
to lose.
So allow me to keep it as my secret weapon.
Okay.
But all the same, it is going to be a contest.
A huge one.
A huge contest.
Okay.
Yes.
So you realize that the people you are going to compete with are also massively adored.
Well, I would not know their caliber as at now. But I know the moment somebody has declared his or her interest in a seat, the competition must be very stiff.
And that's true.
I'm sure each and every participant has arsenals that is he or she is going to display when that time comes.
Same
like me.
Okay.
I would not wish to disclose that now, but what I know at the back of my mind, it is not going to be easy.
It is not
going to be a walk in the park. People must compete.
That is fine. Tell us about your five pillars. What are your maybe what do you think you should be doing? What is your manifesto? in other terms.
Now, in our world, or in every society, but now zeroing on where I come from, number one is water. Number two is good health. Number three is education. Number four is roads. Number three is unemployment.
Number five.
Unemployment.
Okay.
Unemployment runs across board. It is almost with now with everyone. It's just not like when we are leaving school, there was a battery of jobs to choose from. It is not like it is now. Things are a bit different.
So, Mheshimiwa, first priority, water. Talk about water in East Yimbo. As at now, and what you think, what you feel should be done.
Well, Yimbo, water network in Yimbo traces back to the time Honorable William Odongo Mama was the MP. There was an existing water network. It's only that it was never explored and it did not work properly. But this is something that it has been in every leader's mind to do water. Now, Penwa came, agenda was the same. Penwa is an NGO. And I believe they had an assistance from other interested parties who are helping them promote this agenda of water. And in my view, with a good arrangement in water projects in Yimbo, almost every homestead will have water within their doorstep. What am I saying? We have a water point in Yamuni. There is a pump somewhere, it's called Otono or somewhere, it's called Otono. Now, Sibu, we have a water point, pumping point. Wathkopondo, we have a water pumping point. Yerivayala, we have a water pumping point. There's an individual who is also doing one in Abida. All these are water pumping points. Now, recently, there's another one, this side of Pala. An individual has done one supplying got Matar, Ogare, and Ulongi, those areas. In my view, if these teams could be put together, we have one focus. We think of a water point that would supply the whole area. What am I saying? If the pump at Oele stops, the pump at Wathkopondo should be able to assist. The pump at Rivayala should be able to assist. I don't think there is any moment that these pumps would fail at the same time to pump water.
So you are saying there should be unity of purpose within Agola?
Yes.
Water project?
Correct.
Penwa water project?
Penwa project.
And the individuals who already have...
water projects.
These individuals have dug boreholes?
No. They are having pipe waters.
Okay.
Pipe water systems. Now, if we have a common water point, what am I saying? Look at Ndakaine in Nairobi. Water is sourced from there. It's one to a certain area. Treated and then supplied. We'll get a formula whereby even these individuals would benefit from what from their efforts. Not that it will be for nothing, no. There must be a system. But what we need in our world is a water point.
Why do you think this has not happened up to now?
It now depends on the leaders, how their thinking is.
So it is leadership?
It is leadership. Yeah. Because the moment you want to earn credit on your own, on a failed project, then you'd want to do it individually. But if it is a collective thing, you do it as a team. Because the moment you started this, even the MP, even the area MP would assist. Any leader would want to have that word. Assuming now, in Yimbo we've got, in our ward, if we can get a water point that can have even over 100,000 cubic liters at any given time, and it is supplied uniformly in our area, I bet every homestead will have water. Every homestead will have water. And once you have water, you are good to go.
Yeah.
Yes. That's my thinking. Because you would find so many pipes are laid. I come with my pipe, I lay. If somebody else comes with a piece pipe, he lays.
So pipes are crisscrossing
everywhere. Yeah, there is no formula, in my view.
As one of those who are in a, as a member of the Yimbo East community, have you tried talking to the people who are in charge of water to do something even before you become the MCA?
Right now, I've not done.
Okay.
You know, in politics and as a politician, they have vested interests. People create enmity where it should not even be. Because my suggestion, if I give you a point as a politician, you take it, I'm undermining you, yet I'm not. You take it that I'm undermining you, and as I said, I'm not. But we just last one to work as a team, so that this water issue, pick on water, take it to the goal. Don't leave it katikati. You put rotten pipes. Pipes that are not going to last even for a year or two. They burst. Let's do quality work. If it is water, gentlemen, let's have water. Right now, you see in our area where I come from, you find people going as far as what Kokoto to look for water.
From Angwenya?
From Angwenya.
Uh-huh.
They go looking for water. Something that we did when we were young people. I can tell you, me, I used to carry water with my head, using a sufuria, going that distance, either warrior or what cocoa.
So about water, it is networking, coming together, yes, consolidating all that is there.
Correct.
So that every home has water.
Correct.
Let's go health.
Health, Malimo. Health is universal. We have so many players in health. There are NGOs who are also in health. But I will go for the local one, who is Nyamrero. Nyamrero ought to be empowered. Empowerment does not only mean money. It also requires resources, equipment, tools of work.
Yeah.
Nyamrero, I believe, if they could be empowered, then these small issues like Matano? Matano what? Cases. Matano cases could be handled. Malaria could be handled. Even the malaria could have the facilities to detect, to attend to these people. Some of these things, we need not to go and kill in health.
Right centers. Now, they are paid 1,500 per month,
which is below par.
Who pays them?
I don't know, but I'm told it comes from the county and it's not regular.
It's not regular.
It is not regular. I'm
it
told
comes when they want.
When they want. They pay it when they want.
Mm.
Right? Now, if we could get a formula like it is done in other areas, this Nyamarema person ought to be empowered. Snake bites. It is surprising that
it's a big issue.
It's a big issue. That once you are bitten with a snake, the only thing you think about is death. Nothing else. The vaccine, antivenom.
Yeah, antivenom. Yeah.
None of our hospitals in the area has that.
And I'm told that should be kept under refrigeration.
Yes.
Which most of our health centers do not have.
But like Kusigu has power.
Yeah.
I think it has power.
Mm-hmm.
Gotmatara has power.
Mm-hmm.
Am I right?
So what could be the issue? Why don't they have that anti-venom?
I would summarize it with the poor leadership.
Mm.
Yeah.
Okay.
If we've known, like in Baringo, Baringo is known for snake bites.
Mm.
Those things are kept almost in every dispensary, right?
Mm-hmm.
Usibu is not far from Uluo. Usibu is not far from Otamo. Usibu is not far from the interiors like Rahongo and ABC. Assuming we know antivenom is kept at Usibu where there is refrigeration,
mm-hmm.
a snake bite happens in those any of those areas.
Mm-hmm.
We have motorbikes. Could run for this item, bring it. Now, it could do what? It could be used for the treatment.
Yeah,
isn't it?
Mm-hmm.
The antivenom.
Mm-hmm.
So there is no question about antivenom not being kept in the whole world. Honestly.
Yeah, it should be there.
It should be there.
Like Radier Health Center has a power line up to the health center.
Yes.
But the health center itself does not get any service because power has not been connected inside.
Why?
You are the politicians.
I will ask why.
Yeah. I'm asking why? Because you are the politicians.
I may not have an answer. Then I would ask whoever is sitting on that seat, why?
Uh-huh.
Why is it so? Because the power connection last mile was saying to health centers, hospitals, schools,
mm-hmm.
and really other government institutions, but there is not them.
And therefore, we should be having like antivenom should be in every health center,
in my view.
Mm.
Hypertensive drugs.
Mm.
You know, it's a common condition
very
that
common.
Is killing so many.
Yeah.
People are suffering hypertensive.
Mm.
Hypertension cases.
Mm.
These drugs should be kept almost in every hospital.
Mm.
Diabetes. All these are conditions that are long term. They live with us.
Mm.
You may have forgotten to take your drug just for a day. Sometimes it may put you in a very bad condition. If Radier has it, and you know it has this, they could not be varieties, but there could be one that controls the hypertension. The moment I have an attack, I'll walk to Radia.
Yeah.
And tell the nurse who is in charge, please, am I hypertensive? I missed to take my drugs.
Please, what is
yeah, dispense one for me.
Mm-hmm.
Of course, I would have saved life. Malaria is mm-hmm. common in our area.
Very common.
Why don't we have those drugs kept with us? The malaria drugs.
Mm-hmm.
I would ask, the Minister of Health, say account.
Mm.
So there's a CS for health.
There is.
Yes.
Mm.
Why are these grants being taken?
Now, Mheshimiwa, education.
Education.
First, where did you learn?
Primary, class 1 to class 3, I was in just a primary school.
Class 1 to class 3?
Yes. Class 4 to class 7. I was in Wandeo primary school. Now, secondary school, I went to Bakenango.
Okay.
Secondary school. After that, I went to Gaibatula.
Mm-hmm. High school. For A levels?
For A levels.
Okay.
Yeah.
Uh-huh. When was this? Gaibatula?
That was 1988.
Oh, 88, 89. So you were 1 year behind me.
Yes.
I did my A levels in 87, 88.
In
1989.
Yeah.
What else did you do after that, and how has it helped you up to now?
Now, Mwalimu, I was lucky enough that immediately after school, I got employed.
Okay.
I got employed as a police officer.
Immediately after school?
Immediately
after
school.
That was 1990?
No. That's in 1989.
Uh-huh. What business is this you are doing?
I'm doing security business.
Okay.
Yes.
Borrowed from the police experience?
Exactly.
Okay.
Of course. borrowed from police experience. Transferred it here. I've done it now for quite some time, from the time I left the force to date. And I'm not complaining. Just putting some food on my table.
Okay. How would that impact to the community? Your security business?
My security business, as it is now, in the village, I think I have about 57 guys I've employed just from the village. I've not sourced anybody from outside. Maybe if there is one or two, but the rest are coming from our ward. This has gone from Yimbo, CI, and Bond. But most of them are coming from our place. Here in Nairobi, I also have staff. Some of them are from our place. Some of them were my campaigners.
Okay.
When I was campaigning in 2017.
Mm-hmm.
Some of them do not have.
Are you saying therefore that you can never employ Elisha's campaigners or Tiato's campaigners?
If I get, I employ. I don't have any problem.
Okay.
Yes. Because so long as you deliver, employment is delivery.
Okay.
And when they are employing actually for business, you have to deliver. I don't want to know where you come from, because I don't want to know whom you are campaigning for. That is immaterial for me.
So you are saying the door is open for
them? The door is open for them.
They can approach you for employment?
Oh yes.
Okay.
Oh yes, I'll give them. And okay. There's a boy I have employed who was campaigning for that yet.
Mm-hmm.
He's working for me.
Okay.
Yeah. And many others. So, me, I don't have any boundary. And I should not be ill. That's being ill-mannered.
Otiato was a police officer.
Yes.
You are a police officer.
Yes.
What is it about Yimbo Eastern police officers?
Police is a job.
Mm.
Just like any other job. We had families who were sinking, but they were brought up by police officers.
Mm.
Being a police is not a crime. You're a teacher.
Mm.
Has it stopped you from being a... what is your profession now? What we are doing now here?
Journalist.
Journalist.
Yes.
Has it stopped you from being a
journalist? No, it has not. It has expanded my view.
My view.
Mm.
Police, just like any other job.
Mm.
The other day, people were being recruited.
Mm.
Thousands and thousands of people came from Yimbo to go and then they look for this job. Yes. Why were they going to look for a job if it is a bad job?
Mm.
It's not a bad job. Police, it is your character. If you are ill-mannered, you'll be ill-mannered.
Mm.
But if you are a good person, even if you be in the police, you be a teacher, you be what, you'll remain to be a good person.
Okay.
So, there has been that misconception of police in our world. But I will tell you that families, which has been brought up by those policemen.
You go to church?
I go to church.
Which church?
ACK.
ACK.
Yes.
You are an ardent member of ACK.
Ardent member and sits in the synod, which is the cabinet of the diocese of Bondo diocese.
Okay.
Yes.
That's fine.
Yes. So, the police notion, I would want to ask our people, just like any other job, it is. Those bad manners you see people are doing, I mean the police are doing, those are individual. That's not what people are taught at Igaju or at Kasi, where police, the PTC. No. Those are individual characters. Let somebody has that individual character. Mwizi ni mwizi. Even if you do what, if you turn to be a thief, you're a thief.
But point setting.
Setting it is.
Yeah. Yeah. Now, tell us about education.
Now,
the future of education in East Timor.
Education is white. And when we talk of education, education starts from home. And right now, the government has brought in the CBC. The CBC actually is taking you back home.
Seriously.
That in case you got a talent, if it is dancing, you pick on dancing. If it is boxing, you go on boxing. If it is football, you pick on football. But right now, as it is, we have the nursery schools. Nursery schools, people attend nursery schools at a very tender age. A very young, indeed. Now, I would say the county government has tried on this by putting nursery schools almost in every primary school. Some are standalone, like there's one in Tenagok.
Yeah.
And where I come from, there's also a standalone.
Okay.
Meaning, like I'll talk for Angwenyo, if it is to now distribute the children, there's Jusa, there's Ombasa, then there's Muguna. Those are closed primary schools that are now above nursery level.
Yeah.
I would say that right, in that distribution.
Muguna has a nursery school?
It has.
Just like Jusa and...
Correct.
Okay.
Yes.
Mm.
And
they're top class.
They're top class.
They're top class.
Angwenyo has a nursery school. Mm-hmm. But you know, Angwenyo does not have primary school.
Okay.
So of course, when their children graduate, they either go to Jusa, Muguna or Ombasa.
Okay.
For upper classes.
Okay.
Which is good.
Yeah.
Radier the same. I mean, Kanyagol the same. It could go to Alinga,
yeah,
Ramogi, or Jusa.
Jusa.
Mm. All these are primary schools now. Okay, even though they have their own nursery schools,
yeah,
but these children,
they have the capacity,
they have to graduate to those other schools.
Okay.
Now, we have the nursery schools. We have teachers being employed by the county government.
Well, now they are paid by the county government.
They are paid by the county government. Because education under county is only for the nursery.
Okay.
Not primary school.
As at now, are they paid by the county or the parents?
No, they are paid. They are supposed to be paid by the county.
Are they? Are they paid by...
I may not confirm that.
Oh.
Because that, I believe there are cases whereby sometimes parents are asked,
okay,
they are requested to chip in. Because there could be some teachers who are not employed by the county government, and of which, of course, the county government is not going to pay them.
Mm.
It's the parents to foot that gap. I would not say it is wrong, because it is a practice that is being now done in Kenya country, right?
Mm.
The whole country is being done. So Yimbo cannot be exception.
So far on nursery preschool education, you,
yes,
feel at least things are working.
Things are working, man.
Mm-hmm.
Things are working.
Anything more about education? What would you do to uplift the education standards? Or are they already at the best level?
The Englishman said O level.
Mm-hmm.
Which to me it means ordinary level.
Yeah.
Achieving that ordinary level, at least one has knowledge which can take him or her somewhere else. This is the fight we should be fighting to make sure that in our world, at least each and every person goes to ordinary level. Things are going to mix up because of the new system, which to me, this new system, the CBC thing, is okay.
Yeah.
But those who are not in that bracket now, it could be our responsibility as leaders to make sure that at least each and every member of the society, especially the youth, allow me to say the youth now,
mm-hmm,
get that ordinary certificate, the O-level certificate.
Mm-hmm.
This was the core employment basis during our time. After ordinary level, the next thing was to look for a job.
Yeah.
Which to me now, to anybody else sitting to you, those jobs are not there. Am I right?
Yeah, you're right.
Those jobs are not there.
Mm.
And if they are there,
there is border jobs.
There's border is not bad.
Mm.
It's not a bad job.
Mm.
But I will reserve my further comments on that.
Mm.
I don't want to talk about border because it's another option of employment in our society now. Everywhere, even in Nairobi.
Yeah.
People, boys are looking for boda, even ladies are now going for boda.
Mm-hmm.
Because if you cannot get what you had learned at the moment, I mean, you want to feed,
mm-hmm,
you have some 2 or 3 months to
look
feed,
for a recourse.
You have to look for a recourse.
Mm-hmm.
Now, for us to achieve this, the government has talked of bursary.
Mm-hmm.
why can't we get a formula
that giving out the
give bursaries that it reaches each and every person in high school without much ado, without conditions, no bottlenecks. You go, you know you're in school, you are entitled for this amount.
But now some people are more endowed than others.
Yes.
If a bursary is done at the same time, don't you think those who are so much disadvantaged or those who are so much vulnerable will not get the best benefit of the bursaries?
Now, Walimu, you know, when you give birth to a child, the child is your responsibility. The government helps you in a small way. The responsibility of this child from day one to mission is you. The government has slashed the school fees for the scholars. They have said they're paying almost in total. You've chosen to take your child to a boarding school. But you see, when a teacher is in class, they don't say now we are teaching boarders and now we are teaching the scholars.
Yeah.
You are taught in the same way.
Mm.
I'll give you an example. I'm coming from Angwenya, and Angwenya has a secondary school, which is a walking distance to my home. Why should my child be in a boarding school?
So we cut the court according to our sizes?
We cut the court according to our sizes.
And make sure everybody has the ordinary level education or beyond?
Or beyond.
Okay.
Sometimes, I know like ladies, the girl child that becomes so much vulnerable.
Mm.
There's so many spears that are hitting them left and right.
Yeah.
To say the least, pregnancy.
Mm.
Molestation by men. So one would choose maybe my girl to be a boarder, just to keep up from men preying on them.
Mm-hmm. So them preying on men. Doesn't that happen?
I will not say
it's not common.
It is not common. It's not a common practice.
Mm-hmm.
But it's the other way around.
Mm-hmm.
Sometimes a parent will choose to keep the child in a boarding school, purposely to safeguard her from this menace. It's a menace now.
Mm-hmm.
It's something that is being preached in churches, everywhere. Everywhere you go now, people are trying to safeguard on
What about if my child has been called to a model school like St. Mary's Yala?
Yes.
Do I still take the child to Jusa Secondary because it is near and affordable to me?
Those are isolated cases. We said there before, you cut according to your size. If a parent is able, why not take the child to St. Mary's? But still, this child should benefit from the bursary that is being given out to others. If the bursary for those high schools, because schools also have categories, like Maranda and all those things, those other schools, there's a category. If St. Mary's is 25,000, let that child benefit from the 25,000 shillings that he or she is supposed to. I mean, Yala is being a boys' school. He has to get the 25,000 shares.
Oh, from the bursary?
From the bursary.
Oh, okay.
Yes. It doesn't matter which school you've gone to.
Mm.
But
there are calibers on how to even pay the bursary.
Bursaries. There must be an assistance from the government
okay.
to assist these children, wherever they have gone. Which, okay. right,
you talked about CBC and the talent scouting. Honorable Francis Otiato has done something about sporting, and there's a football academy and all that. What else would you do, or what would you comment about that?
Now, he has started. It is our responsibility to boost it up.
Okay.
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
We make sure it goes to the goal.
Yeah.
How do you do it? It is football.
Mm-hmm.
Now, football is about talent, and there are those people we call talent spotters.
Mm-hmm.
Now, like you get a coach of a team, a bigger team, to come and scout for your players, maybe to pick one or two to take to a big team, you'd have scored.
Yeah. And you'll net something.
You'll net something out of it.
Uh-huh.
With the sporting activity, I would add more.
Okay.
Like
through connections.
Like I see, setting up a gymnasium.
Mm. Yeah.
In our area. Mm-hmm. Gym is an art.
Yeah.
It's also healthy.
Somebody will be employed as a gym instructor.
A gym instructor.
Okay.
Students will be coming here. It is healthy to gym.
Mm.
Me myself, I'm a gym. And I gym a lot.
Okay.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Now, I have a program for the youths. We are doing, we are shooting movies around Gotramogi.
Uh-huh.
I don't know whether you've seen that, the Spear and the Bead on YouTube,
uh-huh.
Sweet Reality Kenya TV.
Uh-huh.
Don't you think those are some of the things that we should be thinking about now that Ramogi or Yimbo is endowed with a lot of natural resources, lakes, mountains and all that? We are even better than Nigeria on sceneries. What do you think? What would you do for the youths in such a program? And even the old, because anybody can act.
Of course, this is drama. This is Sophia. Is it Sophia in TV?
Maria.
Maria.
Mm.
Those are local activities. There is mother-in-law.
Mm.
People are earning out of those things.
Mm.
In my view, you set up a theater there. Therefore, like the Nigerians,
mm.
you watch their Niger things. Those things are locally done.
Yeah.
There is nothing international there. We make it international by buying their things. In my view, probably think of setting up a theater. Even choir, you forgot.
Mm-hmm.
Singing.
Mm-hmm.
Singing is an art,
yeah.
Right? We will be producing videos, we will be producing songs.
Mm-hmm.
It's not only a handler.
Mm-hmm.
Even singing as a choir for the church, or just singing for entertainment.
Yeah.
Mungano Choir sings for the president.
Mm-hmm.
And I believe whenever they go for those songs, to see, I mean to participate.
Something must get
into their pockets.
Yeah,
so with cool. The theater, in my view, could even identify land for the theater.
Mm-hmm.
And we promote this thing to good.
Same is happening in Machakos.
Oh, of course.
Yeah.
Yes.
Machakos is thriving because of Alfred.
Yes.
Yeah.
You remember which program did he have?
The
Cobra Squad.
The Cobra Squad.
Yes.
Yeah.
Mm. That was local.
Mm.
We could have our Cobra Squad in Gotham.
Mm.
And we continue. We have the sceneries.
Mm.
Yes.
That's fine.
Yes.
Our road network. Are we doing well?
Road network in Yimbo. Currently, I would say it's not very bad. So many roads have been opened. The only challenge they could be having is good workmanship. When I talk of good workmanship, it means during rainy seasons, we rendered that impossible. I know it's not a tarmac road.
Yeah.
But even if it is a Maram road, it should be a Maram that you could take us even for a certain number of years.
Mm. I've seen an improvement. There's the culverting.
Great.
That was a very big issue before. Because you could Maram a road, but without culverts, they would wear out very fast.
I'm not an expert on road construction.
Mm.
I would only talk as a layman.
Mm.
Culverting is done, but still it has not stopped the roads from being cut by water during rainy seasons. Meaning the openings have been done.
Mm.
And as I said, these are not tarmac roads that you expect them to last for 10 or 15 years
mm-hmm.
before any damage is realized or other experience.
Mm-hmm.
What I would ask them to do is bush clearances. On these bush clearances, it will help even some of our young men get jobs.
Okay.
Because you find the bushes grow very fast besides the roads. It has been cleared. What remains is where the vehicles pass.
Mm.
The sites where the boundaries of the road are turns into a bush. Which now, if we talk of unemployment, these are areas that employments could be got in a small way by our youths. You remember sometimes before, we used to have rural access roads which were being done by the ministry, like Nyamonye Pala Road, at North Nyamonye Mago Road, Mago Junction to Daraja, to Barkanyango, eventually to Romogi Kodinya, Romogi Sidewalk. It was being done by people who are using their manual hands with the help of the Ministry of Public Works. Such programs could be also be introduced in a small way after it has been done by the county, which is massive.
So in short, you are saying you would introduce Kazi kwa Vijana?
Kazi kwa Vijana, okay. in a different way, let's say like those ones. That's all I could say about roads.
Okay.
They are not badly off, because we say some of these roads are being done by the county government.
Some,
but I must appreciate our area MP,
okay,
Mheshimiwa Gideon Machanga. He has done so well.
Okay.
Me personally, there's a road he took it. It's close to my home. He did it. It belongs to the county.
But it was supposed to be done by the
by county, by the MCA.
Okay.
But since it was taking too long and people were going to him, pleading with him for the roads, he took the initiative of opening all these roads. And they are well done. So with such a combination, that's why I was talking about unity of purpose. If you know you cannot, and there's some leader in your vicinity who can assist you, why don't you approach this leader to help you do the job? Because after all, you are doing it for the community. You're not doing it for yourself.
It's true.
Yes.
Food security is a major issue.
You know,
what should we do going forward?
Yimbo, once we get water, once we have that water I was talking about as my first point, agenda one, food security will be something of the past. Mwalimu, I'm sure you are at home during those years back in the 70s. Could not find any home without kitungu at the behind of the house. And that's food. You could not miss to get a home without sukumawiki. You know kandira. You could not miss kandira. You could not miss bok. You could not miss muto. Cassava was there in plenty. Once we have water, and you have plenty of water, a small farming within your homestead won't be difficult to do. People have talked of big things like, this one which has eventually become a scam. This dual thing, what do you call it?
Oh, okay, greenhouse.
Mm-hmm.
Is it a scam?
That's a scam.
It's not working.
No, it's not working. That's a scam.
Uh-huh.
Yeah. I'm saying without contradiction, it's a scam. Already people are crying. There's somebody who conned people millions of money. It has not worked so well in our area. The only thing that we require is water.
Yeah.
I will give you a very good example why water is the solution. Just past Nyamonye Catholic Church, there's a gentleman, Noah. He's doing a small, it's almost 3 acres, fenced, visually. He's producing a lot. Like now, I know in the next 2 months he'll be having maize. He has cabbages. He has kumawiki. He has kitungu. Just because he has water. Nothing else. He has land, he has water. So that water issue will be a solution to our food security in our region.
Okay.
Only lazy people will go back to begging. There's a young man in he's coming from Ulongo. It's called Okech. I see him in the Facebook, social media. He always posts about what he's doing in his family. If it is true, that is what he's doing, I can tell you that guy never sleeps hungry. He never sleeps hungry. If it is true that whatever he posts is actually what he does, Then I'm telling you, okay, she's
doing it's right. True. With water, you could. Yes. There's a Janice Sadiek.
Yes.
It's called Rastaman.
Yeah.
Rastaman does seedlings.
Yes.
Yeah, and he's selling 10 shillings per one.
Yes.
And he survives. Yes. He can make ends meet just because he regates the whatever, the seedlings.
The seedlings.
Yeah. So it is possible and it works.
Malimu, I tell you, with water, you have a solution. I'm repeating.
Mm.
So, agenda number one, water.
Mm.
Water will bring in food on the table. Water will save you on unemployment at one level.
Mm.
At one point, it will cater for that unemployment element.
Mm.
So, with water in Yimbo, and maybe it's no Yimbo looks like a baby from my geography. Because if I know this, we are inside a bay and we are surrounded by water.
Yeah.
Let's exhaust the avenues of getting this water in every home state.
Finally, electricity. What would you do? Or is it
electricity? Electricity. It's a government thing, a national government thing. Unity of purpose. Talking to other leaders, who is in this case the area MP. An area MP, this docket of electricity directly falls onto him. A good sitting, a good discussion, a good public participation will give us an answer to power distribution in our area. You don't need a rocket science. Because we know, like the area between Mombasa primary secondary school and Got Umaga, there's a very big gap there. There's no power. And so many other areas. I know, but I'll give an example because this way I pass almost every day.
So in short, you're saying your major duty will be on connectivity.
Connectivity.
Yes. Connecting issues with those who can help.
Can help.
Okay.
Yes.
Finally, what is it that look at the camera and tell the Yimbo East people what you feel you will be doing for them?
Ladies and gentlemen, politics is about interest. And politics is also about service to the community, service to the people. My main objective would be to serve you as your area MCA based on your requests. We have a sit down, discuss, agree, and prioritize. Which one do we start with? Besides what I would have put for you as my main agenda, like water, I'm sure every household needs water. Two, you need good health. Key thing, you need food on the table. You need roads to access to transport your commodities, to transport yourself, sick people and all those other things. We need more. But if elected, we'll have a constructive discussion.
If elected or when elected?
When elected. Thank you for correction. When elected, I would want a sit-down, accommodative leadership, whereby you come, the young, the old, the lame, the sick, we meet, agree, this is what we want to do. In other words, I'm talking of detailed public participation. That we agree, common goal, this is what we've agreed. The provincial administration, who are the chiefs, must be accommodated in our development agendas. They must be, because they are the eyes of the government on the ground. Why should we exclude them in our participation? They should be included. Other leaders, whether in national, whether in NGOs, all leaders of the world, we should have a specific date where we discuss development matters in our area. Irrespective of where you come from or where you are working. But so long as you're a leader from Yimbo is good, we should be part and parcel of our development agenda. Mm. I wish you well. As it is now, there is corona. You are asked to sanitize. You are asked to wash your hands. Keep social distance. Corona is real. Ladies and gentlemen, it is real and it is killing. It is our responsibility as the people to take care of ourselves. We love you. We need you come 2022. I'll come for you to ask you for your vote. Sio lazima, but it is your will. If you feel Dick Wandeo is your candidate, please take me. But if you feel you don't want me, kindly don't ask other people not also to ask to deny me their votes. I'm coming for you, ask you for your vote. Please keep it. Be safe. God bless you.
Thank you so much, ladies and gentlemen. This was a Sweet Reality Kenya TV, talking politics and development of Yimbo East. We were with the Honorable Dick Dan Wandeo. I am your presenter, Otieno Isaiah. Until next time, please do subscribe to Sweet Reality Kenya TV and watch more shows on politics and development, especially from Yimbo East Ward. Thank you.
Thank you.